Please welcome to the stage Lori Palmer, Chairman of the Board of Trustees for the Illinois Association of Park Districts, and Tricia Brightlow, Chair of the Board of Directors for the Illinois Park and Recreation Association.
Welcome to the 2023 IAPD IPRA Soaring to New Heights All-Conference Award Luncheon. It is wonderful to see so many of you here today in celebration of Illinois Park District's Forest Preserves, Conservation, Recreation, and Special Recreation Agencies.
Please stand and join us for our national anthem. On the challenges that we have overcome the past few years, we should be incredibly proud. You would be hard-pressed to find another industry with individuals who are as dedicated, innovative, and resilient as those of us working behind the scenes and on the front lines of Illinois parks, recreation, and conservation. Our board members, professionals, and staff have held their heads high and charged forward in overcoming obstacles to keep citizens active, engaged, and healthy.
American rock climber Conrad Anker said, "The summit is what drives us, but the climb itself is what matters." Each of you here today has worked extra hard the past few years to ensure that children, adults of all ages and abilities, and wildlife continue to thrive in the environments that we have helped to create. We all know that it can be an uphill climb, but it is a climb that we are privileged to make with the absolute best commissioners, professionals, staff, and legislators in the nation. Please sit back, relax, and enjoy this video tribute depicting the results of our work and reminding us that together we can climb to great heights and move mountains to make Illinois a better place for all people.
Can almost see it, that dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaken, but I gotta keep trying. Keep my head held high. There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I get there. Ain't about what's waiting on the other side. It's the climb. the struggles I'm facing, the chances I'm taking, sometimes might knock me down, but no, I'm not breaking. I may not know it, but these are the moments that I'm gonna remember most, yeah. Just gotta keep going.
It is always inspiring to see board members, professionals, staff, and volunteers working together to support an outstanding park, recreation, and conservation system in Illinois.
There are more than 6,000 local park sites managed and preserved by more than 450 agencies in Illinois. These agencies employ more than 65,000 people and are governed by 2,100 elected or appointed board members who serve without compensation. Together, these board members and staff create a park, recreation, and conservation system that is admired by states throughout the nation. Today's luncheon honors their great work.
Before lunch is served, we would like to recognize our conference sponsors for their generous support. Thank you to our Ruby sponsor, Cunningham Recreation. Diamond sponsors, Cunningham Recreation, Gaywalt Hamilton Associates, and Imagination. Opal sponsors, Upland Design, WT Group, and Explore Recreation. And Platinum sponsors, ComEd and Nicholas and Associates.
Crystal sponsor, Erickson Engineering Associates. Titanium sponsors, DaySmart Recreation, DLA Architects, and Voyager Nets. Gold sponsors, Ansel Glink and BCI Burke. And silver sponsors, Civic Plus, Field Turf, Hitchcock Design Group, Record a Hit Entertainment, and Smith Group. We are grateful for your support. Thank you.
Please enjoy your lunch. We will be back shortly to continue our program.
While you are enjoying your lunch, please direct your attention to the screens and celebrate the accomplishments and recognition of our member agencies. Please welcome back to the stage Lori Palmer, Chairman of the Board of Trustees for the Illinois Association of Park Districts, and Tricia Brightlow, Chair of the Board of Directors for the Illinois Park and Recreation Association.
This afternoon, we begin special recognition of the 2022 National Gold Medal Award finalists. Agencies that reach the final round of this competition are considered the nation's top in their class. We are proud of all our Illinois finalists. In Class 5, the Deerfield Park District. In Class 4, the Hoffman Estates Park District and the Park District of Oak Park. And in Class 3, the Champaign Park District and the Waukegan Park District.
Will representatives from these agencies please stand? And let's give them another round of applause. Congratulations, and thank you for your dedication and hard work.
Now, will the Board of Trustees of the Illinois Association of Park Districts and the Board of Directors of the Illinois Park and Recreation Association please stand? To each of these boards, thank you for your commitment to further parks, recreation, and conservation. Your leadership is enhancing the quality of life for all Illinois residents.
We also want to thank the Joint Conference Committee for volunteering an enormous amount of their time and energy. IAPD members of the Conference Committee serve 6-year terms, and the IPRA Committee members serve 5 years. It's a long-term commitment that demands many hours. This conference would not be possible without the hard work and dedication of this committee. Joint Conference Committee members, would you please stand? Thank you for sharing your volunteer spirit.
We would like to welcome and recognize the following outstanding members of the Illinois General Assembly who have taken time out of their very busy schedules to join us today. Please hold your applause until all names have been announced. Legislators, please stand as your name is read, and please remain standing so we can all recognize you and all your fellow legislators in attendance. Senator Christina Castro. Senator William Cunningham. Senator Susie Glowiak Hilton. Senator Linda Holmes. Senator Adrian Johnson. Senator David Kaler. Senator Seth Lewis. Senator Robert Martwick. Senator Julie Morrison. Senator Laura Murphy. Senator Jill Tracy. Representative Kelly Burke. Representative Mary Beth Canty. Representative Jonathan Carroll. Representative Terry Costa Howard. Representative Anthony DeLuca. Representative Laura Faber Dias. Representative Brad Fritz. Representative Juhan Gordon Booth. Representative Jackie Haas. Representative Matt Hansen. Representative Maura Hirschhauer. Representative Francis Hurley. Representative Thaddeus Jones. Representative Stephanie Kifowit. Representative Camille Lilly. Representative Joyce Mason. Representative Debbie Myers Martin. Representative Michelle Musman. Representative Jennifer Sanalitro. Representative Dan Ugosti. Speaker of the House, Emmanuel Chris Welch. Representative Maurice A. West. Representative Janet Yang Rohr. Thank you to all the members of the General Assembly for your support of park districts, forest preserves, conservation, recreation, and special rec.
Now I would like to welcome to the stage IAPD and IPRA Distinguished Accredited Agency Committee Chairman Kevin Dolan and Ryan Reisinger. Illinois is proud of its Distinguished Accreditation Program, which is one of the most rigorous and respected processes an agency can undergo. The evaluation process requires an agency to meet benchmarks in several categories, including legal compliance, general management practices, finance and business operations, facilities and parks, personnel and recreation services. Attaining distinguished accreditation demonstrates that an agency is among the leaders in the state for bringing exceptional services to its residents.
In 2022, the committee conferred this prestigious status on 5 agencies, bringing the total in Illinois to 45 distinguished accredited park and recreation agencies. Accepting the award for the Bartlett Park District are Vice President Diana Gunstein and Executive Director Rita Fletcher. Representing the Freeport Park District are President George Yarzak, Vice President Debbie Schwartz, and Executive Director Ron Schneider. From the Hoffman Estates Park District are President Pat Kinane, Executive Director Craig Talsma, and Superintendent of Special Projects and Executive Assistant Cindy Flynn. Representing the Lamont Park District are President Bill McAdam, Executive Director Louise Igofsky, and Facility and Project Team Coordinator Liz Pesiga. And from the Oak Brook Park District, our Commissioner Lara Sulame, Executive Director Lori Cosi, and Deputy Director Dave Thomas.
Congratulations to these Illinois Distinguished Park and Recreation Accredited Agencies for their commitment to excellence. Learn how your park and rec agency can join this elite group and become an Illinois accredited agency by attending Session 106, State Accreditation, a Blueprint for Excellence, this afternoon at 3:45.
We would also like to recognize the 2022 Agency Showcase winners. Thank you to the 50 agencies that participated by submitting hundreds of individual items for judging. Thank you to the outside professional judges and committee members from within the communications and marketing section that assisted with this year's competition. Last night, all category awards were presented at the C&M section's annual business meeting.
I would like to announce the overall winners of the 2022 Agency Showcase. Please hold your applause until all the winning agencies are announced. In third place, the Wheeling Park District. In second place, Northbrook Park District. And in first place, the Downers Grove Park District.
Congratulations to our Agency Showcase winners. The People's Choice Award will be presented at the IAPD Annual Business Meeting tomorrow at 3:30 in Grand Ballroom AB East Tower Gold Level.
This year's Agency Showcase submissions are displayed in Grand Hall M through N East Tower Gold Level until 4 o'clock p.m. today. Don't forget to stop by and vote for your favorite Agency Showcase display for the People's Choice Award. Again, congratulations to all our winners.
At this time, please join me in welcoming to the stage the President and Chief Executive Officer of the Illinois Association of Park Districts, Peter Murphy.
Well, good afternoon. It is great to see you all here today. It's been said that you should celebrate what you want to see more of. And as I look around the room, I am confident that we have been celebrating with this intention throughout the years because of the outstanding individuals and agencies gathered here today. This awards luncheon inspires and motivates us to put our dreams into action. And I can honestly say that Illinois Park Recreation and Conservation Agencies get more successful every single year. Today we recognize outstanding representatives of the Illinois Park Recreation and Conservation Mission. These individuals are exceptional leaders in their communities who know that success isn't just about what you accomplish in your life, it's also about what you inspire others to do.
Park districts, forest preserves, conservation, recreation, and special recreation agencies are among our state's greatest assets. They provide opportunities to enhance physical and mental health, improve property values, attract business and workers, beautify our communities, and serve as learning labs and outdoor classrooms for our students. Our continued success as the nation's leader in providing these benefits would not be possible without the unwavering support of the Illinois General Assembly. With so many legislators here today, I want to take this opportunity to thank all of you for everything you do in supporting our mission. At this time, we would like to honor three members of the Illinois General Assembly whose commitment to advancing park and recreational opportunities for Illinois citizens has been truly outstanding.
Our first outstanding legislator is Senator Robert Markwick. Senator Markwick, will you please come forward and be recognized? Since joining the General Assembly in 2013, Senator Markwick has been a leading voice for local government and particular park districts and forest preserves. In fact, he has sponsored not one, but two legislative platform bills for the IAPD. In 2014, as a member of the House of Representatives, he sponsored House Bill 4597, which allows park districts to use conventional loans in short-term financing. This tool has been particularly helpful when addressing short-term cash flow needs because it's faster and more cost-effective than other options, thereby saving park districts and their taxpayers time and money. During the 101st General Assembly, he sponsored Senate Bill 1273, which helps protect taxpayers and land transactions by ensuring that park districts receive fair market value. Senator Markwit has consistently supported IEPD's other platform bills, and he has courageously defended local control throughout the last decade when there has been momentum on short-sighted proposals to freeze or reduce property taxes on a statewide basis. For his steadfast support of parks and recreation, we are delighted to honor Senator Robert Markwit with the Illinois Association of Park Districts Outstanding Legislator of the Year Award. Senator Markwit.
Wow. Thank you very much. This is an incredible honor. I just want to say a few words about what the park meant to me, right? I mean, we're here at the Illinois Association of Park Districts, but everybody had a park. And the park meant a lot to me. It was where I played my first game. It's where I sunk my first basket, where I hit my first home run. It's where I got my first job. I learned so much at the park. I learned how to teach at the park as a swimming lessons teacher and eventually a Little League baseball coach. But it was the lessons that I learned at the park that were the most important to me. And I learned the importance of what it means and to grow up in a community where you've got a healthy park district for healthy recreation, the importance of that to everyone. I have to tell you, the work that I've done that you recognize for me for is not something that was hard to do, because it's the right thing to do to stand up for parks and for people who serve in local government trying to do the right thing. And I just, like I said, maybe I don't feel like I'm worthy of this, but I will tell you this, I'm so grateful for this honor. I assure you that as long as I serve in that General Assembly, I will continue to try and earn it. So thank you very much. I'm grateful.
We are proud to honor another outstanding member of the Illinois General Assembly, Senator Jill Tracy. Would you please come forward and be recognized?
Senator Tracy is no stranger to park districts. After all, before joining the General Assembly, she served as a commissioner on the Mount Sterling Park Board for more than 13 years. During her many years of service in the General Assembly, first as a member of the House of Representatives, and now as a member of the Senate, Senator Tracy has been an advocate for local government. Time and time again, she's been willing to speak out to defend local control. In 2019, she sponsored IEPD's platform bill, House Bill 2081, which provides for the continuation of staggered terms for park boards when terms are reduced from 6 to 4 years on a 7-member board. Senator Tracy has also served on numerous Senate committees that impact IEPD member agencies, including the Executive Committee, the Revenue Committee, and as Minority Spokesperson of the Environment and Conservation Committee. Like Senator Markwit, Senator Tracy has participated in the legislative panel at the IEPD Legislative Conference, and despite her busy schedule, her door has always been open. For her remarkable dedication and support, we are pleased to honor Senator Jill Tracy with the Illinois Association of Park Districts Outstanding Legislator of the Year Award. Senator Tracy.
Well, thank you. I too am incredibly honored. So many worthy legislators that I serve with, but I certainly appreciate this honor. Park districts and forest preserves and the like, everything that enhances recreation in the state of Illinois is a bipartisan issue in the State House. So many issues are not, but I can tell you, you see so many legislators here today because we all support your efforts and we appreciate what you do. By being a park district commissioner or a trustee, I understand the commitment to be a volunteer. I was visiting with my daughter this morning saying I was going to the Park District Association meeting, and I looked at her and I said, you think you should get an award too, don't you? Because our families are involved when we serve as a volunteer in anything, but certainly as a park district commissioner. And I came from a very small park district, and we formed it, And then we started filling it out, and then we started building parks and park equipment and the like, very small budget. But the first thing you do is get your Park District Association handbook that's been written by Peter Murphy. And they were so gracious whenever we'd call. Our little district didn't have enough money to be a member. And but they always helped us. And I serve a very rural district of 12 counties in West Central Illinois. And those that are able to get a taxing district passed know that it will enhance their community. In Little Brown County, we were able in the 90s to get a library district passed, and then later a park district passed. Very conservative, very frugal, very not a high-income communities in that Little Brown County. But they understood the value of libraries and the values of a park district, how it enhances your community, how it provides recreational opportunities, how it provides families opportunities to have a place to go to the parks and enjoy the outdoors. And then they understand it builds their community with economic development. It enhances their community to anyone who would want to stay in the community or anyone who would want to move into that community. And that's why you have people like yourselves that are invested in your passion for parks and recreation. And then my hats are off to those who work in the area. You don't get into parks and recreation as a major and a career for maybe the monetary rewards, right? Just saying. But but you get into it because it's a opportunity to build your community. You have a passion. You know what it does to build up your community in so many ways. And we saw that during the pandemic, that it helped physical health, mental health of people to be able to get out to the great outdoors and enjoy that. And so my hats are off to all of you that work in the industry, to those that volunteer to serve on those boards, to your families that support you in those efforts, whether it's having my kids plant trees, or just sharing your time with a park board or a recreation facility. It's what we do. And so tonight, just go home and thank your families for allowing you to do what you do. And I want to thank you for doing what you do. And I want to thank my legislative colleagues for helping us do what we do and support and promote parks. And also, never forget to remind us to make you a budget priority, okay? Thank you.
Last, but certainly not least, we are very proud to honor Representative Maurice West. Representative West, would you please come forward and be recognized?
Since joining the General Assembly in 2019, Representative West's support for IEPD has been unwavering. For example, last year he sponsored House Bill 4348, which is an IEPD legislative platform bill that expanded eligibility for law enforcement camera grants to park districts, forest preserves, and conservation districts. Although he quickly passed the bill in the House, his work was not finished. After the bill stalled in the Senate, Representative West worked through the final hours of session to get the measure over the finish line. Because of these extraordinary efforts, this IEPD platform measure is now law. He has a strong voice when it comes to positive impact that park districts have within local communities, particularly with regard to youth. But Representative West isn't all talk. He has consistently backed up his words with significant financial support, bringing back millions of dollars in grant funding to the Rockford Park District for summer youth employment, after school and violence prevention programming, and capital grants. For his extraordinary commitment and service, we are delighted to honor Representative Maurice West with the Illinois Association of Park Districts Outstanding Legislator of the Year Award. Representative West.
Good afternoon, everyone. I gotta tell you, my Rockford family knows, and some of my colleagues know, I'm a preacher as well. So I'm a preaching politician, and y'all just gave me a microphone. Y'all gave me beautiful faces. I could see myself, I'm ready to preach, but I promise you, I won't be long. Rockford Park District, I love you. To my family who's here, as I was trying to get my speech together, the only thing I could think of was memories. When I was getting my first sermon together, and I was nervous as all get out, I went to the Rock River Trails, owned by the Park District. When I was thinking about running for office for state representative, which a lot of you may think was the craziest idea ever, right? I went to Senesippi Park to clear my head and get the peace that I needed to make this happen. It was the parks that helped me to get to that answer that I needed. When I was dealing with a broken heart, losing a loved one, and it was mental anguish that was the forefront of my life, it was Dahlquist Park that helped me to put things in perspective so I can move forward again. The work that you all do in the parks, you transform lives, you save lives. And when it comes to the Park District, and a lot of my colleagues know this, as an elected leader, you have to have a certain guard up. Because I use myself, for example, hey, representative, I like that three-piece with that maroon tie. You put that together real nice. Now listen, we need $2.5 million. It's always it's mainly transactional, right? If I say no, you're gonna try to run against me, right? But I never felt that way with the Rockford Park District. Our relationship is transformational. They ask me for things, I make it happen, and they show their love right back. And for that, I will always be grateful to you. To my wife, to my baby girl who's 2, I'm hoping that I'm still making you proud. To my staff who's here with me, both on the state side and the political side, I couldn't be here without you. But to my parents, I definitely couldn't be here without you. We all know that. But the true heroes are all of you. If you all recall in 2020 when the pandemic struck, at least in Rockford, we had to take down the basketball nets and the tennis nets. And what happened right after that? Youth crime went up. So there's a direct correlation with the work that you do and the wealth that our youth are able to understand for themselves. It comes from the work that you all do. The true heroes are all of you. So if I could 2 fish and 5 loaves this bad boy, I would give it to you. But since I can't, I'm going to gladly accept it and thank you. And you will always have a supporter in me. Thank you so much.
Join me in welcoming to the stage the Executive Director of the Illinois Park and Recreation Association, Barbara Arango.
Thank you, Tricia. What an outstanding start to our awards presentation. It's such an honor to be here on stage today to help recognize all of our amazing award winners. The IPRA Young Professional Award recognizes an up-and-coming leader in the field of parks and recreation and is given to an individual with fewer than 8 years of experience who shows a great deal of promise in becoming a future leader in the field. The Illinois Park and Recreation Foundation is sponsoring this award with an addition of a voucher for up to $500 to support our award recipients' continuing professional education. As we hear from Jeff Bougereau, Executive Director of the Vernon Hills Park District, please join me in congratulating the IPRA Young Professional of the Year from the Vernon Hills Park District, Lacey Marinenko. Lacey, please join us on stage.
Lacey's journey with the Vernon Hills Park District began 7 years ago when she was hired as a certified fitness instructor. It wasn't long before her stellar work ethic and positive attitude were recognized with 2 promotions, landing her in her current role as facility manager. Lacey oversees the full operations of the 33,000 square foot Lakeview Fitness Center, managing multiple budgets, and developing strategies for member recruitment and retention. She has been a key participant on the project team for the fitness center's multi-million dollar renovation, giving thoughtful input that considers fiscal responsibility and keeps the members' best interests in mind. Beyond her regular responsibilities, she volunteered to become a certified CPR and first aid instructor, providing required training for all full-time and part-time staff. She's also a member of the district's safety and wellness committees. In her spare time, she serves on the Joint Conference Committee, Facility Management Section Executive Board, and Local High School Career Advisory Council. Lacey's dedication, sense of integrity, and value are immeasurable. She sets the bar high for herself and her team. Under her quiet and effective leadership, our fitness facility has seen a 50% increase in programming, tremendous growth in membership, and improved community involvement. Her exemplary leadership is reflected in staff retention, which is at an all-time high. It is a great privilege to see her honored with the IPRA Young Professional of the Year Award.
Wow, Jeff, I can't believe you did that. Thank you. I'm at a complete loss for words. I had no idea. I work for a fantastic park district. I have an amazing executive director, an amazing board, and the staff I work with is just simply amazing. So thank you so much.
Our next award is the IAPD Rising Star Award, which recognizes an elected board member who is serving in their first term and demonstrates exceptional dedication and commitment. This year's Rising Star excels in her position with her park district and is always looking for ways to serve her community. As we hear from Jesse Quigley, Assistant to the Executive Director of the Hanover Park Park District, please join me in congratulating the winner of this year's Rising Star Award from Hanover Park Park District, Laura Riley. Laura, please join us on stage.
Laura joined the Hanover Park Park District's Board of Commissioners in 2020 after her work with two other organizations connected her to our parks, programs, and events. A 10-year member of the Ann Fox Elementary School Parent-Teacher Association, Laura used her expertise and ingenuity to increase their finances from $1,000 to $10,000 in a single year. Some of these funds were used to assist the Hanover Park Park District in cleaning up parks around the school. During her 7 years of service to the Village of Hanover Park Special Events Committee, she identified several opportunities for collaboration between the Park District and the Village. Laura's gift for establishing valuable partnerships has strengthened the bond between the Park District and the Village and has created an environment of mutual respect and trust. Our two organizations now co-sponsor a Ronald McDonald House charity event and the annual Village Toy Drive. Laura was instrumental in helping the Park District find locations within the elementary schools for indoor sports programs, and she even found the time in her busy schedule to coach two Park District soccer teams. She values continuing education, making IAPD's boot camp a high priority. Her strong volunteer spirit is an outstanding asset to our Park District, and we are excited to see how this rising star shines in the years to come. It's an honor to see Laura recognized with the IAPD Rising Star Award.
Congratulations. Thank you so much. Okay, I'm about to cry. Did not know that Jessica did these awesome pictures of me. So I just want to say thank you to the Hanover Park Park District, to the staff, and to the board. When I first became a commissioner, they were welcome arms, and they were so nice when I came aboard. It wasn't just about being on the seat, to be honest with you. I don't even know how to play soccer. Didn't even know the sport. So I'm more of a softball, basketball kind of girl. But I just felt like it wasn't just about being in that seat. I wanted to be out in that community, be in the field with the kids and teach, you know, sports and I just, like I said, a loss of words, but I really enjoy working with these kids in the Park District and working with the kids with soccer and basketball, and I can't wait for the future. So thank you guys so much.
Thank you. Congratulations.
The IPRA Community Impact Award is presented to a current Illinois Park and Recreation professional who has made a significant impact in the community they serve through their involvement with local, community, nonprofit, and business organizations or government agencies. This award celebrates those professionals who are not currently executive directors. As we hear Bloomingdale Park District's Director of Marketing and Communications, Lana Converso, describe her achievements, please give a round of applause to our Community Impact Award winner from the Bloomingdale Park District, Sandy Van Gundy. Sandy, please join us on stage.
For 27 years, Sandy has displayed an unwavering dedication to improving quality of life and making memories for the people we serve. Sandy leads with compassion, clarity, and a personable approach in every aspect of her job. Even amid a global pandemic, she remained focused, strategizing with other community leaders to ensure that preschool and remote learning programs were safe and accessible to all in need. She develops innovative concepts to grow recreation in Bloomingdale. Her idea to expand December programs into a month-long holiday celebration culminated in a festival of lights with an ambiance of community spirit and holiday cheer. This magical festival has cultivated partnerships with community groups and has grown from dozens to thousands of annual participants. Sandy's many accomplishments include partnering with Lake Park High School to expand adult programming, developing the Superpass program, allowing Roselle and Bloomingdale residents to enjoy aquatic facilities at reduced rates, and partnering with governmental agencies to create biking, walking, and holiday events. She works with residents to award much-needed program scholarships, and she led her staff in reprogramming activities to provide reprieve from isolation and fear during the pandemic. Sandy is a highly respected professional who is committed to creating an environment in which colleagues and community members form strong bonds and friendships. Her impact on the Bloomingdale community is immeasurable. It is an honor to see her receive the IPRA Community Impact Award.
Oh my goodness, that was such a big surprise. You guys keep a good secret over there. You know what? I love the community I work in. I have to thank my director, my past directors, our current board, past board members, because I know there's one or two of you out there as well. And working with the community brings so much joy, and there's so much appreciation out there when we accomplish things together, and we can do these big events or small events, from a Festival of Lights, a big one, to a small one of just presenting what the parks do to a second grade class. It has been a joy of mine to work with the community and my colleagues out there, my amazing rec team. You guys are wonderful. I appreciate everything you do. And thank you so much for this honor.
Each year, IAPD presents the Honored Professional Award to someone who excels as a leader in the Park District field. Recipients demonstrate remarkable talents in encouraging local board members to excel as citizen advocates in advancing parks, recreation, and conservation. This year, we are delighted to honor an individual who has made a tremendous impact on his park district through his steady leadership, enthusiastic support of board member education, and the ability to form strong partnerships within his community. As we listen to Director of Communications and Marketing for the Cary Park District, Katie Hughes will describe his achievements. Please join me in congratulating, from the Cary Park District, Dan Jones. Dan, please join us on stage.
For more than a decade, Dan has provided expert leadership as executive director of the Cary Park District, overseeing 862 acres consisting of 6 facilities, 33 parks, an Illinois nature preserve, and 6.5 miles of trail. He is gifted with an array of talents, including the ability to excel in master planning, formulate positive relationships, and inspire others to greatness. Dan believes in continuing education and has been a faithful participant in IAPD webinars and programs, including the Legal Symposium, Leadership Institute, and Best of the Best Awards Gala. He has led the Park District through 2 comprehensive master plans, facilitated several playground renovations, revitalized 2 parks, renovated the community center and maintenance facility, and oversaw construction of Sunburst Bay Aquatic Center, all without a tax increase. Dan assisted the village in negotiating a developer donation agreement, which resulted in $350,000 to fund trail construction. The Park District leveraged the investment into a $1.1 million ITEP grant for property improvements and 1.5 miles of additional trail. Dan shares his expertise generously, serving on the Joint Distinguished Park and Recreation Accreditation Committee, presenting at the conference, and serving on the Northern Illinois Special Recreation Association Board. Under his leadership, the Park District has been recognized as a 4-time Illinois Distinguished Accredited Agency. Dan's exceptional leadership, professionalism, and strategic rationale only scratch the surface of his incredible impact. We are pleased to see him receive the IAPD Honored Professional Award.
Well, I would just like to say first, this is terrifying to be up here. And I'm sure this is a kick for some of the people from the Cary Park District who know that whenever we have ribbon cuttings or things of that nature, I don't like to be in the pictures. I like to be in the background and get our board and staff out in front. But thank you to the board. Thank you to the staff of the Cary Park District. A quote comes to mind, which is, if I can see further, it means I stood on the shoulder of giants. When I think about that now, I want to apply it to the Cary Park District and say, we being the Cary Park District, when we can see further, it's because we stood shoulder to shoulder with giants. The giants are the staff and the board of the Cary Park District. So my thank you to all of you for all of your hard work. That's it. God bless and have a great conference.
The IPRA Champions for Change Award recognizes an agency with a unique and exemplary practice of increasing access and fostering diversity and inclusion within their community or organization. These are measurable practices that remove barriers, result in positive social change, and inspire others to follow in their path. As we hear from their Director of Brand Strategy and Community Engagement, Anna Avels, please give a round of applause to this year's winner, the Glenview Park District. With Dave Dillon, Vice President, and Michael McCarty, Executive Director of the Glenview Park District, please join us on stage.
When the Glenview Park District began developing our most recent 10-year master plan in 2016, we identified the need to create a more welcoming environment for all community members. The ripple effects of this goal have led to a better understanding between individuals and broadened our view of the district and the world around us. The Glenview Park District strengthened our commitment to diversity, equity, and inclusion. We created policies to protect rights of transgender staff and patrons, and we have held trainings on gender identity. We engaged in a safe zone conversation and unconscious bias training with the IPRA Diversity Committee, and we formed an internal committee to examine biases and find ways to advance our DEI and accessibility initiatives. Highlights of this committee's work include creating an employee DEIA survey to identify areas of improvement, reviewing holidays, celebrations, and acknowledgments on social media for inclusion, working with outside organizations to bring LGBTQ training to staff, and analyzing hiring practices to attract diverse candidates. We increased programming aimed at diverse groups and celebrated Pride Month with specially themed events. Our registration and job application software have been updated with more inclusive options, and we have doubled our scholarship budget to assist low-income families. The Glenview Park District is a leader in cultivating a sense of belonging among employees and patrons. We truly are champions for change, and we are honored to receive this award.
Thank you very much. This is, anyone who knows me knows that this is important work that that we're doing, and many of you are also doing the same type of work. We're truly humbled and honored to have this recognition. At the Glenview Park District, we're committed to be on this journey to ensure that everyone at the Glenview Park District in our community feels welcome and to be more inclusive, to be more diverse, equitable in the delivery of our services and our parks. And it doesn't happen with just one person. It happens with everybody working together, staff and the board. Many of the staff that are on our DEI committee and our board members are over there for the work that you do day in and day out. Thank you for everything that you do to make our community better and to live up to the guiding principles that we have. We know this journey that we're on is, there's really no end point because there's a lot to do. There's day-to-day actions, and along the way, we want to live up to those guiding principles. We're also humbled because I know all of you in this room are on the same journey, to really be the leaders of being inclusive and equitable in our communities. And our two great state associations, IAPD and IPRA, they are leading the nation. You are all leading the nation in this work. So, let's continue to be the leader to make our communities a better place to live, work, and play for all. Let's continue to elevate equity, to activate diversity, and to lead inclusively. And this award really is a testament to all of you. Let's continue to do it together. Thank you.
Our next award is the Mike Cassidy Commissioner Community Service Award, which pays homage to Mike Cassidy's spirited 35-year commitment as a dedicated commissioner of the Freeport Park District, earning him the nickname Mr. Parks. Mike Cassidy's volunteer spirit is reflected in those who demonstrate the highest degree of community service and personal integrity. As we hear from Jeff Janda, Executive Director of the Streamwood Park District, highlight his accomplishments, please join me in congratulating our Mike Cassidy Commissioner Community Service Award winner from the Streamwood Park District, Bill Wright. Bill, will you please come to the stage?
Bill's congenial personality, steadfast leadership, and heartfelt dedication to his community are qualities that capture the spirit of Mike Cassidy's legacy. A 15-year commissioner of the Streamwood Park District, Bill has consistently proven that when he puts his mind to something, things get done. He creates personal relationships with businesses, legislators, and local officials to secure funding for facilities, parks, playgrounds, and educational opportunities that preserve and expand resources for future generations. Bill's pursuit of cooperative agreements with other agencies has led to the creation of a free youth at risk soccer program and free teen programming, including basketball, concerts, and movies in the park. He helped establish and faithfully volunteers for our Summer Reading in the Parks program, which provides free lunches and early childhood learning activities. He has coached both park district and school soccer, impacting players and families alike with his genuine regard for promoting sportsmanship and integrity. He shares his time and expertise with several community organizations, including serving as chairman of our school district's Alignment Collaborative for Education. His efforts in this role positively impact nearly 40,000 students. In his free time, Bill spends much of December playing Santa for agencies and groups around the community. Bill values community service, donating vast amounts of time and energy to improving the quality of life for others. We are happy to see him recognized with the Mike Cassidy Commissioner Community Service Award.
Well, people who know I'm not often at a loss for words, and I am right now. First off, I better give thanks to my boss, my wife Margie, my sons Will and Ian, who give me unconditional love and support during my years on the board. But I'd also be remiss not to thank the greatest team from Streamwood. Guys, stand up. Guys, no individual wins an award. You do it because you're surrounded by great people. We have a great team. We've done a lot of great things together. But we can't rest on our laurels. We got a lot more to do. And I'm so proud to be a member and a teammate of you guys. This is a great honor in my life to be with you. Thank you very much. God bless you all.
The IPRA Professional of the Year Award is an honor presented to an individual with more than 8 years of full-time service who has made a major contribution to the park and recreation profession. The award recognizes a person who has shown excellence in their field and consistently goes above and beyond the call of duty. As we hear from Drew Kambeck, Performing Arts Supervisor of the Northbrook Park District, please help me congratulate from the Northbrook Park District, Molly Hamer. Molly, please join us on stage.
Molly has served as Executive Director of the Northbrook Park District since 2016. She oversees 543 acres of open space, 36 holes of golf, 13 facilities, 24 parcels of land, 7.7 miles of trails, 18 playgrounds, and multiple athletic areas. She's a true visionary, demonstrating impeccable leadership in guiding the board and staff through a 5-year update to our 10-year comprehensive master plan. Molly led multiple project teams through two construction ventures, including the Techne Prairie Activity Center. This $17.7 million project fulfills 4 of the top 5 investment priorities identified in our master plan, including providing ample space for fitness, active adults, and senior programs. It is the 3rd building in Illinois to earn net zero energy status. Her expertise in completion of a $13.5 million golf facility was invaluable. The project included renovating courses, constructing a new clubhouse, and developing innovative strategies to grow the game through TrackMan range technology, indoor golf simulators, and addition of forward tees. She makes positive connections with community groups such as the Rotary Club of Northbrook and the Northbrook Chamber of Commerce. Molly just doesn't lead. She's an involved professional with the best interests of the staff, the district, and the community at heart. Her strategic decision-making, forward-thinking, fiscal responsibility, and service to the field of parks and recreation are attributes that make Molly this year's IPRA Professional of the Year.
Wow. Well, thank you. Thank you very much. Leave it to Wendy. My administrative assistant handed me notes as I was walking up here, just in case. Oh, she's always a step ahead of me. I am eternally grateful and very, very surprised to have spent a year, all of my years, my entire career in this profession is just something that all of you in this room understand. We do what we love, and we're passionate about the difference that parks and recreation make in a community. I've been so fortunate to work for 3 amazing park districts and have a very supportive family along the way. And our team at Northbrook is truly something special. We have a very intelligent, supportive board that is interested in always doing the right thing and asking the tough questions and helping guide the way. And the team is remarkable. I mean, we have fun together, and we work to do the very best and to produce quality and excellence for our communities. And I know, as each of you are hearing me say this, that you're doing the same thing in your community, and that's something that's so beautiful about our industry. So I just want to say thank you. And what my fellow coworkers always hear me say, remember to play every day. Thanks so much.
The IAPD Commissioner of the Year Award is the association's highest honor. It recognizes a commissioner who shows exceptional commitment and outstanding qualities that support and promote parks, recreation, and conservation in his or her community and throughout the state. This year's recipient has served his community for 2 decades, during which time he has made a tremendous impact on parks and recreation in Illinois. As we listen to Ron Snyder, Executive Director of the Freeport Park District, describe his outstanding service, please join me in congratulating the winner of the IAPD Commissioner of the Year Award from the Freeport Park District, Ken Collin. Ken, will you join us on stage?
Ken has been a trusted commissioner of the Freeport Park District since 2003. He is well known for providing the highest quality parks and facilities to residents while being ethical, transparent, and an outstanding steward of public funds. During Ken's 2 decades of service, the Park District has leveraged local funds with several grant opportunities, including 3 OSLAG grants for an array of projects. These include a state-of-the-art maintenance facility, pathways, an administrative center, and complexes for pickleball courts and ball fields. The Park District also approved a new comprehensive plan and achieved distinguished accredited agency status. Ken has an amazing talent for engaging with community leaders and elevating the awareness of what our Park District is doing in the community. As a result of his efforts, we are recognized as a catalyst to economic development, job creation, health, and wellness. Ken's dedication extends beyond the local level. He is a past chairman of the IAPD board, and he volunteers on IAPD's honors and resolutions, nominating, board development, ambassadors, and executive committees, as well as the Research Advisory Council. He is a strong advocate for recreation, encouraging others to join him for a round of golf, a walk in the park, or a pickleball match. Ken's commitment to his park district, community, and statewide parks and recreation is unmatched. It is a great privilege to see him receive IAPD's highest honor, Commissioner of the Year.
Well, I'm not used to being surprised, but they did a good job. Even my wife couldn't keep this, or kept the secret for me, so her and I just celebrated 50 years together, and I just celebrated. Thank you. I've had one house and one wife, so I'm kind of proud of that. And the 18 years, or next spring, I'm going to retire. I'll be 20 years from the Freeport Park District. But this is truly the best, one of the best organizations I've ever been involved with. Peter is a leader, is amazing. Justin's amazing. I just truly like working with people that are so professional and yet can have fun with a lot of really good personalities. I've made a lot of friends, and I almost hate to step down, but this old dog needs a get out of the way for someone else to pick it up. So, thank you very much. Congratulations. Thank you.
To present this year's Robert Arts Lifetime Achievement Award, I would like to introduce last year's recipient, Executive Director of the Palatine Park District, Mike Clark.
Thank you, Barbara. The IPRA Robert Arts Lifetime Achievement Award is named in honor of Robert Arts, who in 1979 was the newly elected executive director of IAPD. Sadly, his life was cut short, but his vision for parks, recreation, and conservation lives on in his legacy. This award goes to a person whose efforts and contributions have a lasting effect and value on parks and recreation. As we hear about her many accomplishments, please join me in congratulating this year's recipient, my friend and colleague, Executive Director of the Northwest Special Recreation Association, Tracy Crawford. Tracy, will you please join me on the stage?
Northwest Special Recreation Association's Executive Director, Tracy Crawford, has served the park and recreation field for 25 years with unmatched integrity, energy, and enthusiasm. Tracy's progressive leadership has paved the way for therapeutic recreation and diversity, equity, and inclusion. She holds herself and her team to the highest standards and keeps an unwavering focus on what is best for her participants, staff, and agency. Tracy has an extraordinary talent for creating environments of understanding and acceptance. She was instrumental in leading the charge to create safe zone conversations through IPRA. She has facilitated more than 50 conversations about racism, making a tremendous positive impact throughout the state. She shares her knowledge as a speaker and author and is committed to mentoring the next generation with her service to the American Academy for Park and Recreation Administration and several NRPA task forces, including education and training, strategic planning, and inclusion. Tracy has served as an IPRA officer and volunteered her time to the Leadership Academy, Scholarship, and Finance Committees. She was a liaison with the state of Illinois in the pursuit of a Medicare waiver services contract and managed ongoing development efforts with the United States military, Glade Sports America, and U.S. Paralympics to create a broad spectrum of recreation opportunities for children and adults. Tracy is the epitome of everything the Robert Arts Lifetime Achievement Award stands for. It is an honor to see her recognized.
I just can't right now. I'm floored. And so many people have said it's so hard to floor me. This is really an emotional time because the last time I stood on this stage was 18 years ago when I was the president for IPRA. And my mom and dad were in the audience, and my mom is no longer with us. And I think it's immediately when I heard my name and I was standing here, I was like, oh my God, the person that was my champion is not here. But you're all here. And I just can't tell you how much this means. I look out, and so many of you have been my mentors. And plus, I'm not old enough to get this, am I? I mean, 25, you can get an award like that? I have had the honor of working with so many of you. And you've grown up with me, or I've grown up with you. I was that very hyperactive professional that people were constantly saying, "Ooh, Tracy, sit down. You're a lot. You're a lot." My board would tell you I'm still a lot, but hopefully they enjoy that energy. I have to thank the three amazing agencies that I really believe made me: Fox Valley Special Recreation Association, North Suburban Special Recreation Association, and my home, Northwest Special Recreation Association. I have to thank my team, who
are amazing. They allow me to spread my wings and to dream. And I have an amazing board who challenges me daily to continue to be the best and do the best. For all of you that are my mentors and friends, I hope I can live up to this. What is happening right now? I will continue every day. You haven't seen the last of me, and I hope that the last thing I do want to say, I couldn't leave the stage, you know me this. I am so proud to look out in this audience and see so much diversity in this room. Yeah, yeah. I mean, and it's more than just diversity, equity, and inclusion. As a good friend of mine would say, it's about belonging, okay? And so if you're in this room and you have that diversity, well, all of us have a level of diversity, but you know what I'm saying. We all stand on the backs of some incredible people. I'm here always. I'm proud to be a part of IPRA and IPD, who are the leaders in this area and have also supported me as I've pushed those initiatives forwards, and I will continue to, because I want to see even more diversity, but I want them to feel like they belong. Thank you.
As our awards presentation comes to a close, let's congratulate all of our winners. Thank you. Thank you for your enthusiasm and dedication. Your commitment to the park recreation and conservation mission is an inspiration to all. I would also like to thank the IAPD and IPRA staff and volunteers who worked many long hours putting this program and conference together. Thank you for all that you do.
Again, congratulations to our award recipients and to each of you working tirelessly behind the scenes to make Illinois a national leader in parks, recreation, and conservation. Enjoy the rest of the conference.